Right, a bit more about where we are. A little look into going back in time. Don't know if you can read that clearly. Yes, I used to go and watch the aeroplanes regularly. We used to have air shows once a year, once every other year, I can't remember exactly. Remember the test flights well. It's a shame all this stuff is tucked out the way in the middle of nowhere. This is nowhere near town centre or any built up area on the outskirts. The Comet debuted in 58. As I said, we're going back in time. This area now is all houses. This area now, it's all built on with houses and a school, and yeah, there's hardly any signs apart from the old hangars, which are used, well, one of the hangars is used as a gym. It's still got the observation tower on it. We can go and have a look at that another day, maybe a little look around that area, but it's very built up, lots of people. The Havilland Vampire. But add some bite to it. Ha ha. Sorry, my hand's a bit shaky. Yeah, trying to keep it still's not easy, especially with arthritis in the shoulders. Ain't you able to read all of this? We've got several more of these plaques. I'm actually here on the way to a walk, so I thought I'd record this. It's a shame it's all dirty. some artwork's awesome. Oh, that hurts the eyes. And that still stands today. Is what's in the museum at Northfield. The only one left in existence apparently, according to that other sign a bit further down. Original artwork. Excellent. Private airfield. Or in this case, the preceding timeline, as we went from modern back to now, because I'm going on a walk this way up through all them trees. Anyway, that was the history of Britain and aviation, Hatfield in Britain and aviation. I might get my words right one day. Anyway, hope you enjoyed that little mini video. Now I'm off for a nice long walk. Bye for now.